Good morning. Here is today's word of blessings for you. 1 Corinthians 16:15 to 21. You know that the household of Stephanas were the first converts in Achaia, and they have devoted themselves to the service of the Lord's people. I urge you, brothers and sisters, to submit to such people and to everyone who joins in the work and labors at it. I was glad when Stephanas, Fortunatus and Achaicus arrived, because they have supplied what was lacking from you. For they refreshed my spirit and yours also. Such men deserve recognition. The churches in the province of Asia send you greetings. Aquila and Priscilla greet you warmly in the Lord, and so does the church that meets at their house. All the brothers and sisters here send you greetings. Greet one another with a holy kiss. I, Paul, write this greeting in my own hand. Today's title is Such Men Deserve Recognition. The Bible is the most wonderful book. It is God's word that reveals the great mysteries of creation, sin and salvation. It also shows us the spiritual realm such as heaven and the glory of God. But have you ever wondered where the sections of the Bible that seem to deal with very ordinary human relationships like today's passage fit in the Bible? In today's passage, Apostle Paul talks about different people who supported the ministry of the gospel for the Corinthians. Obviously, those are the real people that both Paul and the recipients of this letter knew. The way Paul talks about them is also very casual. There is no heavy spiritual stuff here. So do we consider sections like this also inspired the Word of God? What do you think? As a matter of fact, there have been some liberal theologians who said that the sections of the Bible like this are not inspired Word of God at all. Based on such understanding, they reject the traditional views of the Bible that views the whole scripture is inspired. That may sound reasonable to some. But I still believe that the sections of the Bible that look very casual like today's passage are inspired. So what is the basis of my conservative view of these sections as opposed to more liberal views? First, I believe that the scripture itself testifies to the scripture. All scripture is God-breathed and is useful for teaching, rebuking, correcting and training in righteousness, 2 Timothy 3:16. The verse simply says that all scriptures are God-breathed. Secondly, the section of the Bible like today's passage may appear not so holy and inspired to human eyes. It may look like a casual talk between intimate church people. But Apostle Paul here was not using this section of the letter as meaningless and unnecessary casual talk. He was telling and appreciating how God used different people for kingdom work in the real world. In a way, sections like this make the biblical account more authentic to the reader. Having been a pastor for many years, I love sections like this because I can identify the people that Paul talked about with the people that I am encountering every day in church. I have my own Stephanas whose spiritual growth and commitment to the Lord I personally have witnessed. I have my own Fortunatus and Achaicus who willingly gave their hands in times of need. I also had great co-workers like Aquila and Priscilla who devoted everything including their own houses to the service of the Lord. The encouragement to recognize these men is surely inspired to me like all other words of God in the Bible to me if not more. How about you?